this was not exactly the kind of Christmas cheer Jeremiah could have envisioned running into during a mid-December backyard bash. Since none of the present blue and gold Hoofsters ever enjoyed any good win versus their ho-ho host. Five arch-rival triumphs in a row stood at the center of the series. Also not lost in the shuffle was Warrior sharpshooter Zach Sloan sitting out this latest duel, as well as the rest of the season due to a torn ACL. So with all those cards on the round ball table, would the visitors be facing a Silence Knights or the usual Holy Moly Knights? Nightdale started by decking the falls. And Rodney Ellis stringing the freeze. Then the Warriors unwrapped a beast in the box. Javon Monster. Oh, I mean Mercer. Javon Mercer. But then again, this is Ellis's house. So he stopped and plopped from a comfy spot. Curtis Ellerby countered. While Iende Taylor continued his recent interior tear. But his enemy hit the reset button on the Mercer machine. Those two go-to guys traded muscle buckets. Eventually giving Mercer 10 points in 3.5 minutes. Equally aggressive Ellis's 5th and 6th clicks kept the squads almost even. Certainly leaving the final decision up for discussion. Isaiah Holman had his say-so versus a SWAT team here. Carabello bid hello to the holo in response. Dallas's windmill deal to Vaughn Taylor tied it. Wow, what a game already. By the time former Warrior David Ingram entered opposite Holman, it sure looked like they were having fun. Number 11 certainly discovered some heaven via a perfect 5-of-5, 12-point first quarter. So despite not a single turnover, Knightdale was underneath on the scoreboard. Jackson Platts broke the ice in the second. Think with Sim Odin microwaved the premier art hot pocket. Freshman Swishman. But when in need, the Warriors feed that major paint pain. On this night, they also got R.J. Vick on track to the rack. Likewise, Knightdale dialed up Mr. Ellis. Julius Cappelletti soon paid the price for forcing the debut night TO. But gained full payback at the charity strike. His second steal on consecutive possessions packed a transition punch by Corion Horton. Some more Julius juice spurred Holman's pair. Plus the Warriors' largest lead so far. Saddled with foul trouble, Ayinde Taylor still supplied horsepower along back-to-back ricochet raids. Coleman's Free Knox, and Vic's Steel Seal rebuilt the safe spread. Vic's Beyond Beyond expanded it next time. Then a frantic finish ended up much the way the whole thing started. With much more Mercer. Followed by a Chris Mitchell buzzer beater. First minute instructions led to first seconds insertion. Ellis's alley-oop, the soaring sensation, Mitchell. The Warriors refused to be rim-rattled. Not with Mercer mercilessly pounding the glass. And Crudup zip passing to Ellaby for the box. Then it worked hard for Vic reroute to fuel a 5-0 run. Taylor snapped that serve. Some Mitchell magic cast Nightdale's own spell. Intercepted the throw-minum. Recruiter completed the reversal of fortunes. Even though that timeout TO beat that turnover TO, 37. Nightdale was bit by the bugaboo nonetheless. Relieved later pressure using an eyeball of an open Ellaby. Ellis's escapade further impressed. He upped his usual ante with 16 points, 6 assists, 5 rebounds, and 4 steals. Then, tonight's close chances revolved into a crude-up cruise to crush the rally. And RJ Vic sabotaged another fast break to salvage his 11th point. Super soft stuff. That trap knocked out a long way out with a short time left. But the pack plays was not heading for exit just yet. Because Ellis remained all in. Platts just had putback plans to prevent the comeback. Pullman's elusiveness helped heal, bookend DeMonte Vaughn, Ellis triples. In fact, his 12 points, 4 assists, and 4 rebounds were Yuletide Yahoo. And a Mercer drive provided protection too. The chase was on, but the race was won. Larrabee contributed 8 points, 5 rebounds to the Conquer. Mercer, Mass, the man, manufactured 24 points and 18 rebounds. East Wake snapped the neighborhood streak while staking a 7-4 record. Knightdale's second straight defeat dotted its 6-4 slate. This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.